Stanford University.
The Virtual Human Interaction Lab is a human subjects lab, so we seek to use virtual reality as a technology to understand how it interacts with the human perceptual system.
The mission of the lab is to study the psychology of virtual reality. So what happens to the brain when you're inside these virtual environments? How can you use virtual reality to change people's behavior? How can you build applications that leverage virtual reality to help change people's attitudes towards the environment, towards health? How can you use virtual reality to make the world a better place? A recent thesis by Eric Brockbank, who did his master's thesis in symbolic systems in the lab, he wanted to ask the question, how do body movements facilitate learning?
When someone has to problem solve, typically if you're doing a math equation on a piece of paper, you would kind of use your pencil and use your hands to kind of figure it out and work it out. But in virtual reality, you can actually use your full body to interact and work things out. So we call this embodied cognition. It's this idea that I can walk around and I can gesture and use my hands in kind of a more interactive way.
In his experiment, subjects entered virtual reality and they looked down and they saw their body, except we could manipulate whether or not their arms moved virtually. And so Eric was able to answer the unique contribution of seeing your body moved compared to experiencing your body move in terms of how you solve math.
My research actually is going to focus on how immersive is enough. What are the different factors of virtual reality technology and how can we combine them to create a feeling of this feels real? What exactly do we need in order to trick your brain into feeling what we call presence, which is this idea that this virtual stimulus feels like real physical stimulus? There's suddenly a huge interest in how we can use virtual reality, not just as an entertainment medium, but also as a medium for things like education, for social communication, for even things like cognitive therapy. The applications for virtual reality, as it becomes more accessible, more affordable, are infinite. And so understanding what that relationship is like in both a positive and negative sense is going to be very important over the next 10 years.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.